Hi, and welcome to Pendre, and we're on a weekly walkabout this week with my good friend Chris and myself. And the train's just come in, and we're going to have a look around today and have a catch up with what's been happening at Pendre. So let's go and have a look. Okay, in the Temple of Doom.
Thanks.
So we haven't had an update for a while, so we thought we'd have a come and have a look around. It's been very busy Easter. We've had lots of people through. We've had engines running left, right and centre, three on some days. But there are still some things going on in the shop. Even if Chris has been away playing trains elsewhere, he's been to the Bure Valley. Hi to Andrew at the Bure Valley. Yep. Thank you for looking after it, Chris. Thanks for giving him back. What's been going on then, Chris? What's occurring?
Well, this is number two's boiler, which is having its 10-year... it's had its 10-year examination. The tubes have been, new tubes have been fitted, and it's been hydraulically tested to a fairly low mains water pressure. Tubes have all been expanded, and we've got rid of all the leaks. So we're starting to assemble it and get it ready for its proper hydraulic. The hydraulic is where you pump it up with water under pressure, and then you can see if there's any leaks, which is a lot safer than steaming it.
So you do it cold, then hydraulic, and then hot, is it?
You pump it up with water cold, yeah, and just sort out all your leaks, and then you steam test it as well, out of the frames like this, so the boiler inspector can look at all the seams, make sure there's no steam coming out of any of the joints.
So this gets completely up to temperature and pressure before it goes back in the frames, yeah?
Yeah, that's right, and then the boiler inspector's happy
so with it. So it's safe then?
That's it, yep, absolutely.
You like that? And this is the Seven Valley made boiler from 10 years ago, so it's its first overhaul, yeah?
That's right, yeah, you can see the plate works in excellent condition, not needed any renewals, didn't need to do any stays. It was just a straightforward retube, so that was quite good.
And this was due to be ready for middle of May, wasn't it?
Well, it's looking dodgy now, isn't it, unfortunately? But
do what we can. Anyway, what's this blue thing doing in here then? Because that wasn't supposed to happen, was
it? This has poked its nose in and taken the workload off the people off of number two. Because the axle box bearings were getting hot at the back, and so it had to be jacked up, and the axle box, the wheels left on the track, that allows you to get to the axle box bearings, and they've had to be remetalled and the all the lubrication checked out, and whilst doing that, of course, you've got to take the rods off. So
why does an axle box get hot?
When it's not lubricated, or the white metal is worn thin on the actual journal. The white metal actually wears out after a period of time, and it can actually go thin. Or if the white metal doesn't fit the journal properly, all the forces go through certain spots rather than where it's meant to. But the main thing is lack of lubrication.
Okay.
And the actual oil feed box is up there.
Yeah.
And the trimming is in there, which is this little, it's not there actually, it's a piece of wire with some worsted wool, and the oil soaks up the worsted wool and goes down the pipe into a receptacle on top of the axle box, and then it goes into the bearing. So actually, I got it wrong. The tubing's actually in there rather than up there, which means that you need to jack the engine up to get to the trimmings which are in there. Right. Very difficult to access.
But this is now back on its wheels and should be back in action.
Wheels, and it's going back together when the boys are back in.
Very good.
Yep.
Right, well, it's very noisy next door. Let's go and have a look and see what they're doing in there.
This is our Boadicea brake van, a steel-bodied brake van that they used for the engineering trains.
That came from?
Tracoon, I think.
Tracoon, yep. It was a Tracoon van, yeah. Yep.
And being in the Welsh weather, it's rusted badly. The rust was bursting through everywhere. So we got a firm in to shop blast it and then sprayed it quickly with primer. And then it's come into the workshop where Carl has been cutting out and replacing all the rotten metal. So there's a repair section there, there's one there. So all the rust has been chopped out, and he's actually welded in new bits of metal, and the filler is just to make it look pretty, because there was quite a lot of pitting actually in the plate work. So this is almost done. So this will go over to the paint shop and have several good coats of brush paint.
What colours are going to be, Chris?
I thought purple to match the Seven Valleys West Country
engine.
Oh,
what a great idea. Yeah. That would be...
I'm not allowed to decide colour.
It's above our pay grade, isn't it?
We have to ask permission for that.
It's above our pay grade. What else is going on in here today?
So that's that.
Car's making a lot of mess, a lot of dust.
There's a bogie overhaul taking place. Jason Wells is a very keen, skilled volunteer, has taken that over for us. And the bogie on the trolley there has had the had some work to the axle boxes and the guides recently. So that's good. If we go this way, we can see Neil Potts. Neil is machining a brand new casting for a new buffer, to make a new buffer for the open coach. Well, four of them actually.
Yeah.
So if you have a look on the old, come over here, look.
How long have we had these then?
Good few years.
Okay, so you're in stock. You're
in stock. Yes.
You're fashioned them out of a hewn out of a piece of metal. Then.
No.
No. So that's our drawing. So they've got to have the holes put in, and then the top and the bottom have got to be machined. Better to look at that, really, isn't it, than a piece of paper.
So why do you machine the top and bottom?
So it fits, well...
To make it all parallel.
That's what it looks like as it's a casting.
So the casting doesn't really come out that...
Might not be flat.
There's a taper on the casting, you've got two tapers.
It's nice, isn't it? Nice.
And then the buffer heads that will go in, and the studs go through the jaw.
And then we put it in a lathe, and we bore
headstock.
The centre of the casting out.
Cool. Clever stuff, isn't it?
So that's good, yeah. Mm.
Number two.
That's number two. The frames have been painted and the guides, axle box guides, have been measured.
It's got its new petrol engine, obviously, backup power.
I think we'll get shot if we do another wind up, won't we? All the people that believe the last one. So the axle boxes have been put back in the horns to measure the clearances and they're all pretty good. The frames have been painted and shortly that will go back on its wheels. But unfortunately, we're just dealing with number six at the moment.
So we might see some fairly swift progress with number two.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, we've got through most of the gutsy work.
Cool.
Yep.
Cool. Paint shop next?
Paint shop next. Yep. Okay. It's that way.
We know that.
Oh, okay.
So we're in the paint shop, which stops being a paint shop when we run longer trains and we have to open up the doors.
That is a pain.
And Mr. Smith moans at me for carrying passengers and making money that feeds
we do lose a little bit of space.
Feeds his habit of spending money.
That's it, yeah.
But we have been progressing some bits and pieces, and obviously the major project which keeps us active is the open, which is all covered up because we had to open the doors. But there is some progress.
Oh yeah, absolutely. Yep, the window glass is all here now, and that's been cut to suit every aperture.
So take it back one. The new open is different to the old open in that it's going to have glazed ends as well as being open-sided, so it feels like you're in a conservatory with no sides.
Yeah, well, it'd be quite nice if it could go on the front of the train, I suppose, as a saloon.
It could do, couldn't it? Yeah. But it is going to be special and different.
It will be different, that's right. It's more complicated to build because of it, actually.
Yeah.
So that's happened. The chassis, well, I hate the word chassis, it's an automotive term, but the frames underneath are complete, and they've been put on the wheels now for a trowel fitted to the wheels, and they fitted. So in order to do that, they had to be turned upside down. And so we're getting to the stage where the frame can go away for blasting and painting, and then it can come in here, be put on its wheels, and then we'll put the floor in, which we're going to use an Ifor Williams trailer floor.
And, Ivor Williams.
Okay.
How long have you been in Wales now?
What he said. And so then the coach really looks something when it's on its underframe.
Yeah. So we're hoping by the time we get to the middle of summer and peak season, we'll be having a nice new coach by then, won't we, Christopher?
Well, have a go. Yeah, usual answer.
Lack of...
You don't know what else is going to crop up in the meantime, but...
Okay,
we all want to see it running as well.
Yeah, you want out of here, don't you?
Yeah, exactly.
And get something else.
Perhaps you let us have a jolly.
Limping Lulu's then, isn't it?
So can we have a crate of beer and a special train with it?
As long as you get it ready by the start of July, you can have a crate of beer on me.
There you go, it's recorded.
what else is in the paint shop? We've got some green stuff.
See, yeah, we've got two sets of locomotive wheels. They've come back from the Vale of Rideau Railway, where they straightened an axle and fitted crank pins, and they've turned the outside profile of the tyres. So they're almost ready to go back under.
Fine, and we can exclusively reveal, well, not exclusively at all, because it's been talked about already, but number two is coming back into service in TR bronze green. Mm. So that's what it's going to be. It hasn't been that since 1987, I think, something like that. So there we are. That's the excitement for the members, that we're going to get another green loco to go in the fleet, because that's the council policy, TR bronze green. So anyway, that'll look very smart when it comes back, and that should be, well, next couple of months.
We'll see how we go. We got a bit distracted with fixing number six.
You can't keep saying we see how it go. Can't keep saying that.
You could do a proper project plan if you knew everything that was going to crop up in the near future and what your man hours are.
Yeah.
But
fine.
Yeah.
And the boys have been working on some other bits and pieces.
The clock for Wharf Station is finished. That needs to come out of here.
That's great.
We need to work out how we're going to hang it up.
But generally, once we get into the running season, a lot less work can get done in Pendre because they're busy keeping us running. And Chris has got to finish here today and go and fix an air pump that's just broken to get us three steam locos for tomorrow. So he's going to get greasy and dirty.
That'll be fun.
New coaches, of course, yes.
He was meant to prompt me.
I'll prompt you to that. Yeah. What about the new coaches, Chris, that are being built somewhere else?
Yes, we went to the Festinilb last week, and they've completed the new underframe of the first new coach they're building for us. And they've air tested it. It's got all its brake pipe work on. So that's very impressive. And all this steel for the second one has been tacked together, and the third one, the steel was there laid ready to assemble it. So that's good. And we also saw Glenn Williams and looked at his drawings for building the body as well. And all the parts are there for the underframe, for the bogey, sorry. So we've got to supply a few bits to them, but that's looking quite good as well.
Cool. Yeah. Right, well, I think that's a quick, brief overview of what's happening in a very quiet Pendre today, apart from Glenn and his sanding down.
Oh, God.
The railway is now running daily. We have four train services today, and that drops down to three next week. We've got an exciting Back to the 70s weekend at the end of the month over the bank holiday, where we're recreating the 1975 timetable of lots of trains going up the valley and then a shuttle between Abergynolwyn and Nantgwrnawl, just for a bit of change, as long as him there can give me enough locos to do it, or else he'd be pushing the coach up himself. And once we get into May, we've got the Pioneer and Quarryman's trains and lots of other things. So keep an eye on the website. Please do come and have a trip, and we'll see you soon.